In this question, it is saying that a wire fixed at the upper end stretches by length L by applying a force F. Now it is asking work done in a stretching is. Here there is also the direct case we have studied, however we can explain the same here. We are given that a wire is fixed at the upper end. There is a wire, say it is of length L and its Young modulus is Y. At the bottom end we apply a force F and we stretch it by a distance X. So if you wish to calculate the work done by external force, then we can directly state work done by external force in this situation is simply the force multiplied by the displacement of point of application. So this can be simply written as Fx. But when the force is applied during extension, there will be an internal force acting on wire due to which stress will be developed in the wire, which keep on increasing as the wire is elongated. The same thing we have derived in theory also. So here we can say due to stretch, internal force because of elasticity develops stress in wire. Here using Young's modulus, we have here Young modulus we write as a stress by strain. So in this situation we can say stress will be the internal force by cross sectional area of wire if here we can write cross sectional area is A, then it is F by A, and at any point of time the strain will be Y by L, where Y is the extension, intermediate extension in the wire, where Y increases from 0 to X. Y is the instantaneous extension in wire. So Y is the instantaneous extension in wire, so Y overall is increasing from 0 to X. So from here we can see the internal force we are getting is Y A by L times Y, where Y is the extension at any instant. So if we calculate the work done by internal force, or work done against the internal force, then here we can write as it is depending upon Y, it will be integration of Fi dy, which will be integrated from 0 to X. So if we substitute the value of Fi, here we can see this is giving us minus because extension is in downward direction, Fi is in upward direction. So this gives minus Ya by L integration of Y dy from 0 to X, and this giving us a value Y is Y square by 2 on substituting X, thus giving us minus of half Y A by L times X square, and at the final extension X we have for equilibrium of wire, external force is equal to YA by L times X. So here in this situation, if external force is YA by L into X, so here we can substitute YA by L is equals to F by X. And if this is equation 1 and this is equation 2, Here we can write from 1 and 2. This is giving us the total work done against internal force. This can be written as Wi. This is minus half Ya by L x square. If we substitute Ya by L as F by X, this is giving us minus half F by X times X square, which is giving us minus half Fx. And here negative sign denotes, as work is negative, the absorption of energy. This implies here we can say half Fx energy is stored in wire. So if your half Fx energy is stored in wire, this much amount of energy is absorbed by the wire in form of elastic potential energy. This we have used in one previous question which was asked in 2003 also. So here we can say, if we wish to calculate work done by external force, this is simply Fx. If we calculate the work done in stretching the wire or the elastic energy stored in the wire, that will be half Fx, where X is given us the length L, which is elongated by L. So here we can see we are required to find work done in a stretching. So for external force, the answer should be FL. And if we wish to calculate the energy stored in this wire, this should be taken as FL by 2. But here it is simply asking work done in stretching. So we need to consider the work done by external force, which should be Fx. However, if it is work done by the elastic forces, then it will be taken as FL by 2. So here we can directly write work done in stretching by external force in this question, then the answer should be FL. And if we calculate work done by elastic forces in stretching, then work done by elastic forces in a string is half FL. And here we can say this much amount of energy spent by the external force, this will be against the elastic forces, so this is used in stretching, and the remaining half FL will be dissipated as heat. And here we can write heat dissipation is FL minus half FL, so this is also half FL. So you can state work done in a stretching by elastic forces is half FL, so answer should be D. Whereas the total work done in a stretching as well as the work against dissipation, that will be FL. So answer to this question should be taken as option D.